Good morning, we've just arrived in Johannesburg. We'll be heading to Safari, so we're not going to have any internet reception. So I thought that for the next week, I'll just keep filming videos, then I'll make a cool little movie and put it together. Here's the first one. Good morning. Good morning. It's too early. Our first meal selection. Porridge, fire, and a cream soda float. Hi everyone! Long drive, getting comfy.
I'm doing this one again.
I'm sleeping on Jules. Good night. And we have arrived at the Back to Basics bush camp in the Mbikwe Game Reserve. And this is our luxury cabin for the week. We're going to be spending some good nights around this campfire. Guys getting a tour of the bar.
Okay.
And the most important part, in my opinion, where the meals are given.
You may think this one is young, but he's been kicked out from the group already.
How do you tell?
That's about 400 meters, not for the male in the males than the females. So that's the boss.
Just almost at the end of our first game drive. It's night time on our first day at Back to Basics experience, and look at this. Nothing but nature. I love you. Okay, another thing I love, this is our first night drive. I love it, and Johnny, our guide, is so excellent. Before we go on our first game drive at 6. Stay ready and you never have to get ready. Oh, look who's come to join me. Oh shit, you can't see her. It's Jules somewhere in there. Good morning everyone!
Morning JP!
Let's try that again. Good morning everyone!
Morning JP!
Good morning boys. Good morning.
It's definitely posing for you.
Yeah.
I think it's front end.
Blue steel.
That's awesome. That's the lion that killed the wildebeest. You can see the wildebeest there in the middle of the bush. She's covered it. And what's she covered in? Earth. We've literally just been hunting lions for about 40 minutes with the most incredible tracker, Johnny, just found. One. Just found a whole herd of elephants. You can't really see.
Big one on the far right.
There's about 15 or 20 elephants here.
That's a bull. That's a male. But because he's with them, doesn't really mean that he's going to be with them forever or he wants
them. Elephant crossing. Beautiful campsite by night. literally the whole campsite is lit by fire lanterns just off the back of a game drive. Everyone is at the bar having a drink, you can't really see. And then we're heading to the most awesome dinner table in the world for a massive dinner. Yeah, baby. Good morning, it's another beautiful day in the bush. That is the donkey boiler, which is basically how we heat all our water. There is our little hut, mine and Jules's. There's huts all around the camp. But now it's 6 a.m. and we are going, look at the sun coming up there. Damn, that's beautiful. Now we are going on our morning game drive. So we'll be out looking for animals, hunting and tracking for the next 4 hours. Yes! Okay, so we just found out that we're going on a morning game drive, and we just found out that when the rangers came to pick us up, that 4 lions were in our camp. Now, in case you didn't know, back to basics experience, we're at a bush camp, which is a kind of natural safari, and there's no separation between us and the reserve, so animals are free to come in the camp. Last night there was a buffalo in the camp, just kind of observing from the outside of the camp, but seriously, 4 lions. Look, I'm not even joking. Guys, 4 lions, yeah. Yeah, 4 lions. Is everyone agreeing? Yeah, Nikki, are you agreeing?
4 lions, absolutely.
4 lions. 4 lions, we saw the tracks. A pride of lions, and you're walking around on your own, going to the toilet at night. Insane. So anyway, on a brighter note, look at that. Welcome to Africa. Driving for 2 minutes and really see how it happens. Look at this little baby one.
Oh, it's the cutest,
it's like my ball. He's so cute. Hello, little guy.
Oh, he's so cute. Oh my goodness.
Just spotted a kudu, a couple of kudu.
Kudu.
Oh,
there's another one. No.
Yeah,
the feet
are
gone.
There's another male on the
there as well.
The males
are
very handsome.
Hey guys, JP here. I'm just in Madikwe Game Reserve and we are on safari. And just beyond those mountains is the Botswana border. There is so much space here, it is incredible. We've just been on a morning game drive and we're stopping for coffee, taking in the view. This is a reminder for you to get outside of the box and into life. And what I mean by this is, some people never experience things like this. They never get outside of the box that is their 9-to-5 job and their weekend lifestyle, going to the same places, spending time with the same people over and over again. Life has so much to offer. There is so much adventure. There is so much challenge. There is so much exploration to go take hold of in life. You've just got to get out of the box. It doesn't have to be a safari. It can be hiking. It can be traveling. It can be cultural experiences. But if you get outside of the box and you step into life, you will experience everything that life has to offer.
You are a part of nature. So go out and connect with nature and connect with yourself, because I promise you, you'll feel in total alignment. You'll feel happy, peaceful, calm, tranquil, and you will feel a part of nature, which is you.
Dream life, chilling and reading. The Magician's Way again. Chilling afternoon. Yeah, baby!
Yeah, baby!
Hello, everybody!
Hello, JP!
Wow!
Hello! I'm going for an afternoon game drive. We had this morning off and yesterday afternoon off, so we're very excited for this.
How's it, bro?
No.
Oi, Machana! Look at the baby.
That's a proper African picture.
That's some nice
balls. Breathing so fast.
He's full, his belly's full, that's why.
Okay, this is what I've done today so far. I've had two workouts, hung out with amazing people, had two coaching sessions, watched a leopard devouring a... Hello, Jules. Hey, what was it eating? A wildebeest. And now we've just seen 2-month-old baby hyenas.
So cute.
And we're just getting started.
Now we're going for sunset drinks.
Sunset drinks. Grape Tizer.
Cabin. So awesome. Lanterns everywhere. And our cool little room. You can't even see anything.
Look at our lanterns.
In the middle of the wild. In the middle of the bush. Behind this, can't really see it, behind this canopy here is literally the bush. And there's about 30 buffalo there right now.
Believe that.
Good morning, Africa.
Woo!
Okay, this is pretty amazing. We've got rhino. Got two rhino here. You can't see, but there's a male lion there. There is a lion up there.
Yeah, look at him up there.
There's lions behind those bushes there. This is an incredible find. Let's see if you can see the male right in the middle of the screen. Just on the top of the bank, there's a lion, a male lion. You can see his mane. He's facing to the left. Two rhino. Rhino having a mud bath. Lioness. And there's another lioness. A cub, I think. Incredible.
You horrible rhino, we wanted to see those cubs.
Can I come this way, Mom? If you can see him, maybe.
Come on, boy, look here. He's got some attitude, this one. Okay, we should probably go about now.
Oh.
Wow, look, stop. Watch.
Only a way that we can run.
Yeah, exactly.
The grass will be gone.
Mr. Lion, look this
Look at all those lions over there. Look at it playing, they're playing, the baby's playing, baby.
They're fighting.
No, the lions are playing.
Okay, well, I'm watching the rhinos.
Oh,
oh. We can see it's so pretty. It's 2 PM females.
So why is he fighting?
Maybe he wants to.
this is a mating play.
Excellent.
You can't have both of them at once.
Excellent.
The one on our side looks.
Oh my god.
Hate each other, yeah. Kill each other.
You're a nasty old man.
Nice to watch them when they
no.
fight.
They must run away.
The one seems to be.
The lion's just watching it.
This is hilarious, he's gonna step on the lion. Oh. Oh my god. The lion's run behind us.
He's not impressed. You have disturbed my slumber.
Now he's getting back to his place.
He just got straight back. He's like, go, we done now.
We're done kids?
Guys.
Just have some breakfast and calm down.
What's in the mud?
Yeah, I don't know why.
It's coming.
Yes, it's coming on the other side of the mud.
He's up. Oh my god, he's beautiful.
Isn't he? Isn't he? Are they cheery, right? You've got a bad tooth or something.
Come to daddy.
The tails. That's it. Go next to your friend.
Leave me alone. It's a no. That's why he's over there. He's pissed off the women. So they've said, no, you go over there. Don't come back till you say it's okay.
Which one is his wife?
They all are.
They're all his wife. What about the other one over there?
Yep.
He's a man.
He's the,
boy.
He's the dominant male.
Oh, look at that.
Jungle.
We're coming to the end of once again an incredible experience. This is one of the most beautiful places I've ever been in my life. Look at this campsite. Right, we are in the middle of the bush. We are in the middle of the Madikwe Game Reserve, and literally there is nothing separating us from the wild. From buffalo, I mean, just down at that corner there, there's been buffalo almost every night. And look at this, look how we've been living. That's been our chill area, socializing circle, and our coaching area as well. I've had a few extraordinary breakthrough coaching sessions with people. I've also delivered some talks.
I've just been doing what I love, really. And right now I'm gonna try and help you. I'm gonna try and sneak up to some zebra so you can see how close we are. Okay, so I'm just sneaking up to one of the cabins. And I know there's zebra just behind the cabin. Hopefully they don't hear me and run away. Hopefully you can hear them, but they're too far away to see. There's one just in the middle there. Anyway. Before it gets too dark, this is where we eat. We have been eating for the last week, a massive, beautiful dinner table. And then over here, you have the most exceptional chill out area. You've got the bar over here, got a little table, and then you can't really see, but there's a living room space here. There's huts all around there. All the way around. And then of course, you've got the Masepa tree. And you've got the sky, which opens up into something so magnificent, probably less than 1% of the world get to see, where the whole star, the whole sky is completely, completely lit up with stars. Every constellation, the Milky Way, it's all very, very clearly visible. Just total gratitude. Good morning. It's 5 a.m. That's my last morning here. I'm gonna soak this place up for everything that it's worth. Meditate, do some exercise, and just listen to nature. There's a thunderstorm right now. Everyone else is asleep. And I'm just walking around the campus into the thunderstorm. Absolutely extraordinary.
Hi guys, I'm here at the Mosetla Bush Camp in the Diqui Game Reserve, and I've been here for a few days and it's been amazing. And while I've been here, I've devised a little 9-step routine to keep me fit while I'm here. So here we go. So this is what we get up to when everyone else is out of the camp. Beautiful.
Yeah, baby.
It's our last morning. Bye, Masetla. I'll miss this camp.
Cause I was a young warthog. Right in our camp. That is amazing. Oi, Pumba. Mm-hmm.
My name's Nikki. I'm from Joburg, so literally 4 hours from Medikwe, from the camp from here. And it's just been the most incredible experience being at Back to Basics. Just incredible camp, being back in nature. There's some zebra and warthog behind, and it's just been the most special experience to sort of, you know, recharge and really get back and sort of get my head in the right space. And even more incredible to have a coaching session with JP here in the bush. Just absolutely fantastic, exactly what I needed after a long tough year, just to kind of put my head in the right space in this gorgeous setting. You really can't get any better than that.
Hey, I'm Lucy. I heard about this Back to Basics experience. A few people came last year and raved about it, so I knew I had to come. Didn't know what to expect, but it's been amazing. Just the animals that we've seen, how close they were to us, the actual place we're staying, it's all been amazing. And they've catered, I'm vegetarian, so they've catered for me, and it was great. So, awesome experience. And I got a coaching session with JP, which again, as always, was great. I've got my homework to do. So I'll be doing that on the way home. You should come, you should do this, have sessions with JP, come and do the Back to Basics experience, it's amazing.
Hi, I'm Jo. I have spent the last 6 days here in the bush, and it has been absolutely an amazing experience. It's so hard to give it words because it's just an experience you have to come and see for yourself. I had a coaching session with JP, which was amazing, and I've got some skills and things to take back and some work that I need to do that I realise once I get home. So yeah, you need to come.